Our state fair is a great state fair. Don't miss it, don't even be late. It's dollars, you don't ask that our state fair is the best state fair in our state. Give me a hand, Gus. Blue boy wants a snack. You know how uppity he gets when he has to travel. Look out, Margie!
Sorry. Our state fair is a great state fair. Don't miss it, don't even be late. It's dollars to donuts that our state fair is the best state fair in our state. Margie, come give me a hand with these pickles. Margie! Oh, where is that girl?
Hey, sis, do you mind? I'm trying to practice here.
Sorry.
Our state fair is a great state fair. Don't miss it, don't even be late. It's dollars and donuts that our state fair is the best state fair in our state. Okay, mister. Now I'll try for that pocket watch. Ding! That's for me. And now I'll try for that pearl necklace in the back row. Ding! Hand over the pearls, mister. That's for you, Eleanor.
I made him a nice soft bed, Gus. You know how Blue Boy feels about potholes, and I can't be expected to miss them all. It's high time Dave Miller got here with that special fee. You know how peckish Blue Boy gets when he's under pressure.
Afternoon, April. Wayne.
Not giving up on hope on seeing you, Dave.
Why you got your galoshes on for, Mr. Miller? Are they predicting bad weather?
Nope, they're predicting good weather. That's why I got my galoshes on.
I'll tell you, Dave, Blue Boy's going to win the grand sweepstakes so easy, they're going to ask J. Edgar Hoover to look into it.
I wouldn't count on it, Abel.
Well, why not? He's the best born in the state.
Well, if that's true, he's as good as me.
Oh, what are you talking about?
Abel, if man or hog ever got the easy title, just once. The eternal stars, the quick making melody, their spheres, and all that.
Poppycock. I say Blue Boy's the best, and so will the judges.
They might. Boy, there's something might happen to Waiter Margie. Mark my words, Abel. There's a lot of compensation in this world. For every good, there's a bad. Now, Ralph Waldo Emerson.
I don't care what Waldo Emerson says. I've got $5 says we go to the fair, Blue Boy wins the sweepstakes, and nothing bad happens to him, me, or my family.
Well, if you'd asked me, I would have given you 10 to 1, but you didn't. $5.
$5 is right.
I'll be around on Saturday after supper for the money.
Be around with the money, you mean?
Ha! That would be a first.
Oh, bro. He can look at a bed of roses and see ragweed. Waldo Emerson.
Wayne, where's Margie?
I don't know. She's around here somewhere.
Well, I know that.
Okay, mister. Now I'll try for that fake revolver with the genuine simulated pearl handle.
Wait! Wait!
Back here, Eleanor.
Oh, Wayne, I have the most wonderful achievement!
Well, now slow down and tell me.
From State College. Somebody dropped out of the nursing program and I got accepted. I'm going off to college in 10 days.
Well, gee, that's... 10 days?
Of course, now I can't go to the fair.
What are you talking about? I got the 3 days all planned out for us.
Oh, honey bunch, I have a million and one things on my mind.
Well, can't one of them be me? Mm-hmm. I suppose when you come back next year, you'll be educated to the point where I'll sound pretty ignorant. And you won't find me very interesting anymore.
Oh, Wayne, there will never be anybody like you.
It's not somebody like me that I'm worried about. It's some new guy with a blazer and a trust fund.
And just exactly what is that supposed to be? It sounds like you think I'm not to be trusted.
Well, how am I supposed to know what's going on? Between the freshman mixer and traipsing around with more nose control, or whatever you gamma hubba hubba girls call it.
Well, Mr. Gray, I never realized you held me in such low regard.
Now, hold on, Eleanor.
No, I should have known better than to think you'd be happy for me.
Women.
Have you packed yet? put your name Mrs. Abel Free or Mrs. Melissa Free?
Oh, Melissa, I guess. What with your father entering Blue Boy, I wouldn't want the judges to get us mixed up.
I've never seen Daddy so hepped up as he is about Blue Boy winning the sweepstakes.
Oh, sweepstakes, my foot. Your father won't be happy till that pig's made who's who. Oh, Margie!
Oh, sorry, sorry. 1,000 times sorry.
Doesn't know what she's doing 1 minute to the next.
Oh, pickles and pigs. Pigs and pickles. Who cares about the stupid old stain there anyway?
Why, Margaret Elizabeth Brake. You've always loved the fair. What's gotten into you lately anyhow? All you do anymore is sit around and mope.
I don't sit around and mope.
Well, take these pickles out and wrap them up.
Doesn't taste like Graham's. It's black.
I followed her recipe.
No, Mother. You left something out.
Abel Frank, I will not put liquor in my cooking.
You can't make mincemeat without brandy. There ain't no such thing.
I don't approve of it, and I won't do it.
You'll be sorry. You know how the judges at the fair like to take a nip now and again.
Now, what you do in the privacy of our home is nobody's business but yours. But I will not broadcast the drunken habits of this family to the entire state. Now, go get those suitcases from the hall.
On my way, Mother.
No, I won't do it. Thank you.
Hi, Harry, what do you know?
Not much.
Yep.
Guess who?
Hi, Harry.
I saw something this morning.
What?
Sweetest bit of farmland this side of Davenport. I was thinking of putting in a bid. That is, if you like it.
Has it got a house on it?
Yeah, but it's too old. Let's build a new one.
Why? I like old houses.
It wouldn't go with our modern kind of farm. Scientific irrigation, electric milking machines, and get this, individual hen roosts. Separate and sanitary, like a chicken maternity ward. No old platform and shingle type house for us. There's this new kind of plastic. We rather think each other.
Is it pretty?
Sure. Where do you see the catalog? They even tell you how to furnish it. No carpets or rugs. They're just dust collectors.
What's on the floors?
Linoleum.
Throughout the whole house?
Slick and smooth and easy to keep clean. Like every room in the house was a bathroom.
Sounds real cozy.
Sure, only way to live. Everything's sealed. Sure wish I was going to the fair with them. Only I can't neglect like Daisy just when she's about to calve.
I understand, Harry. I know the farm comes first.
Well, I've been thinking. After our wedding.
Now, Harry!
I know, it's not for sure yet. But I was thinking maybe we take a trip somewhere.
You mean a honeymoon?
That's what. And somewhere nice, too. Like, maybe Chicago. See the Museum of Science and Industry. Take them to the stockyards. Of course, one night we'd probably get all slickered up and we'd paint the town. Maybe go dancing.
Sounds like a great trip, Harry.
Can I take that as a yes?
Mm-hmm. Maybe.
Maybe. It's always maybe with you. How long are you going to keep it waiting, Marge? After all, we graduated high school now. It's time to get on with our lives.
All right, Harry. I'll give you an answer after the fair.
You mean it, Marge?
I promise.
Oh, that's swell.
Thank you.
the one ride on the Tilt-A-Whirl.
Hey, there's the new block. Come on, feel lucky.
We gotta get over to the roller coaster before the line gets too long.
Roller coaster? Last year you were scared senseless, said you'd never ride it again.
Well, that was last year.
I don't like going on these stupid rides. That's kid stuff.
All right, Grandpa Moses. You go watch the fertilizer demonstration. I must have some fun.
Just be careful. I'm supposed to be keeping an eye on you.
Thank you, big brother. I promise not to have a second cup of candy in front of Muck.
And Brian, I'm playing Jazz Robinson upon here.
I tell you what, Charlie. Boss is doing some lousy you science, my bae. It really stuck me this time.
He thinks you've gotten too big for your britches, so he's taking you down, babe.
What I covered during the war, for crying out loud, I covered the top. I covered Midway.
Yeah, well, now you're covering the Midway. Look, enjoy the sunshine, do your job, and shut up about it.
I ain't got no interest in this human interest junk.
Sun and
to a refrigeration breakdown, there will be no butter sculpture of The Last Supper.
So where to next, Bobby Locks? Please, anything but the roller coaster again.
Well, you ride all day, you didn't have a chance.
One in Chicago, now that's a roller coaster. One of the beach near LA too, that's alright. One on Coney Island, that's okay too. But one in Chicago, now that's the one. Gotta dip over 200 feet.
You've been everywhere, haven't you?
Seen it all and done it all. Well, no, I haven't. When I first started out in this racket, I worked jobs all over the country. Got a couple lucky breaks as a war correspondent. Wrote some good stuff. Not that it ever led anything like I thought it would. Now I'm stuck in United Press. Used to think I'd get a real job on a real paper.
Well, have you tried?
Tried what?
Writing more good stories to get more attention.
Well, the boss hasn't been giving me the plump assignments lately.
You're covering the fair, aren't you?
Like I said.
Are you kidding? That's the biggest story in the world. Well, my world, anyway. Fair's all about the things in nature. It's about people taking pride in what we do with our lives. Well, what could be more interesting than that?
I like you, Margie Frake.
Well, I like you, too. We barely know each other.
Maybe barely knowing each other isn't so bad. In fact, I could probably just sing about it if I wanted to. Listen here, Bobby Locks. It's not how I'm gonna call it quits. Won't have to ask. I just won't be around. So do you have a date?
Well, my mother's with pickles and mincemeat are being judged tomorrow afternoon.
They can only give them 30 days unless they're convicted of a felony. So what time do they sentence those convicts?
3 o'clock.
3 o'clock, please.
Well, I better be going.
Can I walk you home?
I'm afraid I'd have a hard time explaining you to my parents.
Well, everybody has a hard time explaining me. So I guess I'll say so long.
So long, Pat. And thanks.
Thank you. Few people do. Can I sit down?
Oh, yes, absolutely. I had a nice talk with your father on my way in.
My father?
You know, the chief of police.
Oh, that guy's the oldest guy with whiskers. You didn't actually fall for it, did you?
Yeah, I kind of did. Got to meet the chief's daughter, though. Nice, pretty. In fact, I think she even kind of fell for me.
I'm sure she did.
There's only one problem.
What's that?
She's 11.
I'm really sorry. Listen, you're such a good sport. Can I buy you a beer?
You bet.
Two drafts.
Coming right up, Miss Arden.
So, tell me more about the farm.
You don't want to hear about all of that. It's just a farm.
Closest I ever got to a farm was our fifth floor walk-up in Detroit. We had a window box of geraniums.
So when did you move to Des Moines?
I'm just here working. Last week Grand Rapids, next week Milwaukee.
Don't you ever get lonely being away from your family?
Family? Oh, there are a few people back in Detroit, but they don't really know me anymore. I never look back, only forward. Actually, I'm going to New York.
New York City? Why?
In all modesty, I'm going to be a star. You know, on Broadway.
Say, what's your name anyhow?
Emily. Emily Arden.
Emily Arden. I can see it in lights.
So could I. What I couldn't see in lights was Emma Kozlowski. So, how long are you here for?
We go back to Brunswick on Saturday. Say, maybe we should meet up again. Sometime when you're not working.
I'd like that, Wayne, but let's make sure we understand each other first.
What do you mean?
First rule of show business. Always leave them laughing. Nothing complicated, okay?
Oh, of course. Nothing complicated.
Do you like to dance?
Of course. Do you?
Couldn't you tell?
Didn't we?
Margie.
Oh, yeah, two of us together. Great times.
You know, you certainly are all gussied up just to walk the Midway.
Well, the Midway is very dressy this year.
I'm here to tell you that Blue Boy is the best looking piece of hog flesh in the Hawkeye State.
Did you drop off my pickles and mincemeat?
All signed in and delivered. Now, seeing how this is your mother's big day, I'm going to take everybody out tonight. Dinner, dancing, the whole nine yards.
Oh, Abel, dancing?
You heard me.
Thank you. place to Mrs. Melissa Frey, Bronzewood.
Somebody else is getting all the attention. You coming, Wayne?
I
Gee, I just remembered that I entered the traffic hole. I better be going. I don't want to be late.
Margie?
I promised Betty McGaskey I'd cheer her on in the ice cream crank off of Derek Billion. Bye!
Well, I'm just done in. You know, I never realized what a strain it is to get something you've always wanted.
Now, when Blue Boy upholds his end of the bargain tomorrow, it's going to be a clean sweep for the Frakes of Brunswick. And I'm going to get my $5 from Dave Miller.
We have nothing to remember so far.
Silver.
Stupid beast possibly know about love?
Well, two idiots know about love.
say? Anything you say. Listen to me.
No.
Oh my God. call from the Chicago Trip. Sees the managing editor had to fly to the coast, so he's moved your interview up the first thing tomorrow. We got just enough time to get you on the last train out tonight.
Well, I can't leave now. I told Marge that I'd meet her.
So you'll find another girl in Chicago.
She's not just another girl.
And this is not just another job. This is a chance you've been waiting for, Pat. Now, if you want to throw it all away for some girl you've known for 2 days, it's no skin off my nose. But you better decide fast, because that train's not going to wait.
Same old Pat. Someone?
Yes.
I promise not to tell if you don't.
Pinky swear.
Want me to wait with you?
No, that's okay. You go ahead. Wait. Thanks.
Margie having the time of their lives.
You know, I haven't seen
It's the last night of the fair. You know, we ought to think about loosening the reins on those two.
When I'm worried about Margie, she told Harry she'd give him an answer after the fair, and I'm afraid it's not going to be the one he's been counting on. Then what?
Then she'll marry somebody else.
Well, here it is. The moment every mother dreads. The children have all grown up, and somehow I didn't notice. You know, I'm so used to treating them like my babies. It's a hard habit to break.
That it is. But just think, before long it'll be back the way things used to be. And I'll have you all to myself again. Hiya, Harry.
Aren't you back yet?
No, she and Wayne must still be on the midway.
It's getting pretty late. The fair's over. I'll take a walk up this way. If she gets back, would you tell her I need to talk to her?
Of course. Harry, do you mind some company? I think I'll walk you for
Uh-oh. Waldo Emerson.
I suppose you think I've been drinking.
Well, not till you mentioned it.
Well, I had to. I'm drinking to forget.
Is it working?
No.
Never does.
Oh, I'll never forget Eleanor. I mean Emily.
Oops. A little slip of the tongue?
Oh, how could I be so stupid? I made a complete ass of myself.
Men have been making fools of themselves since Adam and Eve. And I doubt that's going to change anytime soon. Say, this Emily gal, treated you pretty rough?
Yes! She made me feel... No! We had a wonderful time, a trip to the moon.
Well, son, when you fly that high, it most always ends in a bumpy landing.
I don't feel so good.
You don't look so good. Let's say we take a walk and talk it over. Come on, put your arm around your old man's shoulder. That's it.
Pop, do you think Eleanor will ever forgive me?
It's best not to bother Eleanor with all the particulars right now. Sometimes it's more important to forgive yourself.
What you do and I'll do it.
There's nothing you can do.
What have I done wrong?
You haven't done anything wrong.
Then is there somebody else?
No.
Then marry me, Marge.
I can't! Don't you see? I'm not in love with you.
I guess somehow I always knew that. Thought if I stuck around long enough, maybe you'd grow to love you. I guess I'm the kind of guy who needs to be hit on the head with a frying pan before he gets a message. But I've got it now, loud and clear. And here's some news for you, Miss Margie Frake. There'll come a day when you'll be good and sorry you let me get away. I would have given you everything.
Happiest man alive.
And the
luckiest, too.
Hey, Mom, Margie, come out here for a minute.
Go ahead, Honey Bunch. You tell him.
All right. We decided that next year, when Eleanor comes back from college, we're going to get engaged.
From bad to worse.
So, what does that make you now?
Why, they're engaged to be engaged. Congratulations, son.
Thanks, Pop.
Come on, Honey Bunch. Let's go tell my folks.
We haven't heard from Margie yet. Hiya, Margie. Did you have a good time at the fair?
Well, let's just say maybe I've outgrown the fair, Mr. Miller.
What a shame. Something downright tragic must have happened to make you feel that way.
Hiya, Margie.
Ha!
Sorry I'm late.
Where were you? I waited all night on that bench and now you come here and expect me to...
Margie, I got a real job. On a real paper. The Chicago Tribune. I want to take you for a ride on that roller coaster. Margie?
Yes, Pat, yes!